There are strange things out there that seem to have no explanation. Sometimes they are conjured up by the darkest corners of our subconscious. But on occasion, they dwell beyond the confines of our imagination. They may come from another realm, or out of the sky, or from beyond the grave. Once they set foot into our world, the line between dreams and reality becomes unclear. It's our job to investigate these reports and compile the Virginia Paranormal Case Files.
Yeah, I hear it, most of it. So when we moved in April, and what we started to see or started to hear is people walking upstairs that aren't there. It's mostly that. All times of day, at night, we hear it in different rooms. In our bathroom, in the bathtub, we used to take baths in there. There's an overwhelming sense of dread. And so me and our 13-year-old son won't go back in there. It's just a horrible feeling.
Yeah, in the bedroom, in a corner where the door is at, it sounded like footsteps. We thought it was our son, but it wasn't. He was asleep. But constant, just footsteps everywhere.
So. And a dog barking.
That's we have heard what we thought was our other dog barking upstairs, and she was down here when we heard it up there.
Yeah. How long have you lived in this house?
6 months, 7 months.
Yeah, since April of this year.
And would you say the activity started almost immediately when you moved in?
Yes.
That was it.
Yeah, and it was mainly the footsteps that started out with, or was it something more subtle?
It was the footsteps and the overwhelming dread in the upstairs bathroom.
It was pretty immediate.
Now, before you moved into this house, the location you were at, were you experiencing activity just before you moved out?
More so than we were here.
And so I was actually down the street from here.
We used to live about 2 minutes down the road. And the most striking thing that happened to us there was I went outside for coffee at 5 in the morning, heard someone crying for help in the woods in our backyard, and you know, listened a few times to see if it was an animal. It was definitely a boy crying for help. Called the police, they searched, couldn't find anyone. And then he was telling, but not a month later, he was telling our aunt about it, and they heard it too. There's somebody out there screaming for help that's not there. And when we called the police, because we thought it was a child, he said he'd had multiple calls about that person yelling for help. Mm-hmm.
And there was one incident where I was in the backyard with, we didn't have one of our dogs back there. There was this, if you imagine a pogo stick jumping, but a very smooth metallic sound with it, a little smoother. That noise started way back in the woods, close to another house, but it would jump. There's woods back there with leaves, so you would hear the crumbling. There was no crumbling, it just jumped and jumped. And eventually, there's my shed's out there. I went on the concrete of the shed and looked out in the woods, and it jumped right in front of me and didn't move until I moved. Our dog ran to the porch, and they're barkers, but ran to the porch to make a noise and just laid on the porch.
Did any of the footsteps sound like it could have been a dog walking around?
No.
No. And no, it happens when I'm working from home or when we're asleep at night and they're with us. So they can't be just moving around themselves.
And it's in the closet, one of them. And our bedroom's hard floor. So we would have heard the scraping of the floor.
Right.
But this was a thump, thump, as if someone was walking.
That happens every day. We'll be downstairs with all three dogs. Our son will either be asleep in the morning, and it just straight up sounds like he's awake. Like he's up, he's moving. We just think that he is. And then we'll go check, and he's not. He's still asleep. Or then during the day when I'm working, I'll have all three dogs with me. Nobody's moving, and it just sounds like someone's just up there going about their day. And then I go up there and There's nothing. We've had pest control come to check for, they were looking for raccoons, possums, mice, rats, nothing.
Has he experienced anything?
Our son?
Mm-hmm.
Other than, and I can't even say that he would describe it as dread, he just will not go back in the bathtub, but outside of that, he's not mentioned anything.
Around the house, have you guys had anything what seems like misplaced or moved or anything like that?
Yeah. Not obvious though, like not out of sorts, but we definitely find ourselves asking how the heck things got in different places.
Well, I just assume it's her moving it.
But we have also a 13-year-old, and I guess yeah. I hide stuff from him unintentionally. But yeah, we do find that a lot.
I haven't personally paid attention to that, so I can't speak on that, but I don't know if she's noticed it. Yeah.
Any inconveniences in the home, like something that would make you late for something?
We've had a lot of weird stuff happen in this house since we moved in here, from drama that never has happened before. That came pretty hard, to even her cleaning these drawers out in the kitchen and becoming overwhelmed with stuff, which prevented her from doing it, you know.
Our family is typically are pretty normal people, but since we've moved in here, we haven't had any issue, but we have things that are happening to us that are keeping us and are slowing us down as far as the trouble our family has gotten into, just crazy things like legal trouble they're getting in, domestic issues they're getting in, and it's all new. As soon as we moved in here. And I don't know that that's related, but it's inconvenient for us to leave or be able to interact with them anymore.
Yeah. How about antiques in the home? Is there anything in the home that has been bought secondhand, particularly things like mirrors or estate jewelry that passed through from that house to this one?
So my parents recently, when we moved in, there's some pictures upstairs from the Civil War era that were given to me, from World War II era that were given to me, and there's a ship in the living room on our mantle that's from... you know, early 50s that they handed over to me.
Okay.
I do want to point out that for a while with me, I've been experiencing things, so I'm not sure if it's something that could be attached to me that's also causing this, but I've had a lot of, from the scratches at multiple locations to things when I lived in Korea to things, you know, when I was 18, you know.
Oh, so it's followed you that long.
Yeah.
It seems like you've had activity.
And I do remember the point where it started and how it started.
What was that?
I was 18.
Mm-hmm.
A buddy of mine was going through some issues. I guess you can say maybe demonic type stuff.
Right.
Long story short, his eyes were pitch black. He had a coffee table in the air about to slam it on his girlfriend. I stopped him. That night, I fell asleep, and I had this skull on fire in my dream just charge at me, screaming. And then I woke up. And from that point, that's when stuff was not same.
This area and the house we lived in are both on Civil War battlefields. Mm-hmm. And the one we lived in before, we were actually on the gravesite of a Civil War battlefield. Here, I don't know much more about that other than all of these houses from here back is a Civil War battlefield.
Wow. Okay.
So we'll start by kind of walking around the whole perimeter. So we'll start downstairs, just kind of walk along the walls, cut through the middle.
One thing we do, and we don't often get a chance to show about this, is with our baselines, we look for natural gas. And this is the meter we use. It's just a very simple meter that they do have natural gas here. So we want to rule that out as any possibility that that's affecting the people at all. And another thing, if there is any of these elements in the air, could that be impacting the activity that's here in the house? So we want to monitor the atmosphere as much as we can during the course of the investigation, because those changes in the atmosphere are what's going to let us know that something may or may not be here.
Bedroom, right there. I had the window open. I had a sink cleaner earlier. If you want to close the window and turn off whatever's in there, okay. You're welcome to. Where do you want to?
That does look like a fairly old one, huh?
Okay, so right there at the top. Will, do you want to compare with this one here? Seems like we got a fairly steady spike.
Could it be from this picture?
It's possible. Now, there would be no natural explanation for that being from the picture.
Now it's gone.
It's very hard.
Just like that.
It's like it just disappeared, just stopped.
That one's kind of old too.
Yeah, if it is from the picture, like if there's objects that have an attachment or have some kind of energy, that wouldn't be natural. But it's not unheard of by any means.
Nothing at all. It went from going crazy to nothing.
Was it? It was going off just a minute ago?
Mm-hmm. And this one's not spiking at all.
Yeah, we're wondering, was it this bathroom or was it the other one that she said that she doesn't use anymore? I think it's the other one,
It's got to be the other one.
Because I think she said her son doesn't want to use that bathroom anymore.
Because I felt more something in that one.
Did you? See, I haven't even been in that bathroom. Maybe I ought to go over there.
You'll feel it. I think it's because the room is slanted a little bit. So I think it might throw you off and give you the feeling of uneasiness.
Right now, it doesn't feel any worse than it does anywhere else on the second floor. I can see it is the architecture of it, the way that it's constructed, it seems a little strange.
I heard something. So in here, doesn't the ceiling kind of slope?
Yeah, over the bathtub, yeah.
I heard it's a horror technique. It's called the Dutch tilt. It's where you'll see in some movies, like if someone passes out, the camera will turn with them and kind of like fall with them. While in horror movies, if they're trying to convey something, they'll turn the camera slightly. So that way it's kind of at a weird angle.
Okay.
And because of that, it makes you feel unsettled.
Huh.
So that way you kind of view it as a bias, as
right.
Like a horror bias. So with that slant, that slope that's in there right above the bathtub, can kind of give you that feeling.
That feeling.
Yo, that's the attic.
Nice.
Are you? Yep. Yeah, I haven't gotten anything.
Ooh, this is really nice.
Going up right here.
Wow.
So we did our baseline sweep around the house. On the tri-field meter, it never really went up above a 1 on the milligauss scale. However, Will was walking around with the K2 meter. The K2 meter quite often would jump up. A couple of times it went up to orange and red, which means that there was some sort of electromagnetic field going on. when I would put the tri-field meter up next to it to see if I can get the same reading, it wouldn't get the same reading that one was getting. So it would be interesting to see if that goes off and continues throughout the investigation. We'll have to monitor that and see what happens.
Throughout the whole house, there was nothing on the carbon monoxide detector.
Then here, can you make it stop?
Try that again.
That's pretty weird. I mean, it's really going.
Oh, it's on the yellow. Just like I asked.
Yeah, you did ask it to go up to yellow. Why would it stop when you put that near it, though?
Can that throw it off? Like, does that ever throw it off?
No.
It should.
Things, if there's anything here with us right now, can you make it go back to yellow? Crazy, it always goes back to yellow.
It's always when it's being observed that it stops.
We're gonna go in and we're gonna do a spirit box session. And when we do the spirit box session, we're gonna use the splitter. And the splitter's gonna go to the headphones that Linda's gonna listen through, and then another end's gonna go to a speaker so we can hear what's coming through it. That way, of course, she won't hear our questions. She won't be biased in her answers. Whatever she hears come through here, she'll blurt out. We're gonna start upstairs. At the top of the stairs, there's this little, I guess I would describe it as a catwalk that kind of goes across. You can see the door down below. And there were some spikes, some significant spikes up there on the stairs. So we figured if we start up in that area, it might be a perfect passageway where anything might be passing that's curious might come out and talk to us. So we're going to go up there and use the REM pod. We also have the Eggly wheel here. Now this is a device that we've just been recently implementing. And it's basically just this little wheel that is on this little metal post thing, and it spins. It's supposed to measure your vitality. If you take the top off, we found that micro drafts will actually make it spin. So we're going to keep the top on so that no air can get to it. And if it does move, it's not the breeze that's moving. And we're going to see if we can get a spirit to actually reach through and manipulate it. Another means that they may be able to let us know that they're here.
My name is Will.
I'm Jeff.
My name is Emily.
I'm also Will.
And this is Linda down here, listening to the headphones. What's your name? What it sound like?
Did I say
I heard something like with a key in it.
I don't know. I heard something, but I couldn't exactly. I couldn't exactly make out what it said. So we noticed that this device that Will's holding lit up to yellow. He asked if you wanted us to leave, make that light up to yellow. Do you want us to leave?
If you can't light that up to yellow, what I'm holding in my hand is called a voice recorder. You can talk into this and I can be able to hear you. Do whichever one is easiest for you. Talk into this or light up that device to yellow.
That's a weird sound that's coming through there, isn't it? Like it's a...
thing sounds strange.
Sounds like a heartbeat or something like that, you know, like an electronic heartbeat. Is there a particular room up here that you don't want us to go into?
We did hear what sounded like some interesting things coming through the spirit box, and of course we're going to have to go back and listen to the recording. Because a lot of what Linda heard, she said it sounded kind of like radio chatter. There was this low voice that I want to take a closer listen to that was kind of towards the beginning, this low voice that kept coming through, and then a female voice. And then I swear we all heard it say William towards the end there. And Will said that'd be interesting because he's Will, the homeowner's Will, and then what if the ghost name is Will too? We've got a lot of Wills, you know. But Will, you heard those footsteps. Oh, right, you want to elaborate on those a little bit? Both of you, maybe, the footsteps that you heard? Because I felt them. I did feel them. I couldn't pinpoint the direction.
So we were standing right here. I was actually holding the K2 meter. Mm-hmm. And we literally heard 1, 2, 3, 4 coming from up top.
Hey, guys.
Mm-hmm.
So I heard something that sounded like gin over there.
Sounded like what?
A word, gin.
Yeah.
Yeah, I heard that too.
Yeah.
This is my next door neighbor.
Oh.
I did hear that. And we were just talking about gin earlier.
Oh, it just fell asleep.
So I was like, did that say gin or gin?
Brin.
Oh, okay. So it's
the
same sound to it.
Yeah.
Could have been. You know, especially being, if it's attached to the land.
Right.
Could be going back and forth between multiple houses. But they also, from downstairs, they heard somebody walking around in the office while we were up here. So I definitely felt those footsteps.
I could feel them for sure.
Mm-hmm. Hmm. So maybe we should, I don't know, should we head down to that office and see if there's anything going on down there? Mm-hmm. I think we mentioned earlier, like as soon as we came down out of this attic, I had to go back up because I looked around. Will's nowhere around. I go up and he's already sitting up there. I'm like, Will, come on. We got to do our baseline sweeps first. So he's eager to get up there and sit up in that attic, probably with the lights out at the far end, maybe with the REM pod. But maybe before we do that, we should go take a look in this office here and see if we can get anything. Since there were just footsteps, they heard him in there. We heard them upstairs, around this area. A lot of strange noises going on right now. We can't really pinpoint the source of, so let's check it out.
Okay.
I just thought about something too, man. There's that floor up there.
Mm-hmm.
You can't step through that, because if you step through that, you fall through. So
yeah.
There's only one section that you can really step on, which is the wood part.
Yeah.
Yeah. So it's not like they can be walking around out off of that center
like
piece.
No, nothing, no animal or anything could really be up there.
Mm-mm.
Mm-hmm. That's right. Who was walking around in here just a few minutes ago when we were out in the hallway? Who was it that was walking around in this room? Are you still here?
Are you human or not human? Yellow for human, red for not human.
What's that sound that sounds like static? Do you hear that?
I think it's your charger. This power bank.
Oh, is it? It sounds like static?
Yeah, I'm hearing that too.
It might be the speaker. It's something over here. Plugged in.
Oh yeah, it's this right here. Whatever
mm-hmm.
this is right here.
Yeah.
This thing's real smart. I think maybe if we stop acknowledging it.
Maybe.
We'll get more because I noticed it only, like, we'll ask a question and it won't do anything. But then we'll start talking about something else and then it'll answer the question.
Yeah, and she just said herself downstairs that it's always when they're, you know, not talking about it or not thinking about it that it always kicks up.
Will's doing a real time EVP session, so he can hear exactly what's coming through the recorder.
The only thing I could hear is sometimes the wind outside and a car going by.
So in a sense, with not acknowledging, what are some examples of what we could perhaps do to invoke some sort of a response?
Set up a camera in the most active part and then go somewhere else.
Mm-hmm. Good idea.
Like, remember what we did with the phone? That we got all that footage, everything that I asked and I told it to do yellow. After we left, it turned yellow. And mm-hmm.
Yeah, it didn't do it, so we left.
That's right.
Yeah, we could certainly leave the REM pod up here somewhere, like maybe in the hallway outside of the, like between this bedroom door and the utility room. And maybe leave a camera on it.
Has her son felt anything, heard anything?
I think she said the only thing was just that weird feeling in the bathroom. Mm. I wonder if it's going to rain tomorrow.
Probably.
You want to talk about where we're going tomorrow?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, absolutely. What are you guys doing tomorrow night? You want to come on another investigation?
I would love to. She has to work, so...
Yeah, I have to work tomorrow.
Oh, no. Well, tomorrow, we got a call just the other day, actually. These people are moving into this old house mm-hmm. up in Quinton. And it turns out that they found out it actually was used as a hospital during the Civil War. And they've got all kinds of stuff going on in the house.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm.
And what time do you work?
8 o'clock.
What time do you guys plan on starting the investigation?
That one...
Probably about.
I'll have to look at what I. I'll have to look at what I told her.
Yeah.
And what time do you get off?
Three.
You guys think it would be? If she drops me off, you guys think you'd be done before, like around three? That well, after three, so that way she can pick me up.
What, like 3 a.m?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Well, I don't know. Maybe. I guess it depends on what time we start. I don't know.
Yeah, that sounded like it came from downstairs.
We tried an indirect approach back there in the bedroom where we just had a regular conversation, just talked about random stuff. And this is an interesting theory. A lot of times when people are just conversing, they'll get some activity. Something will kind of jump in the conversation. It didn't seem that this happened at first glance, but what we're going to do is leave the recorder going in that room where the REM pod is on the floor, and the REM pod has not gone off this entire time. So if it goes off while we're not in that room, that's definitely going to be interesting. We're going to come back, we're going to check on that, and then determine where to go from there based on the responses that we do or do not get through this voice recorder.
So as part of tradition, if there's a bathtub, a closet, or an attic, I will go in it. The first place I'm going to be going to is going to be the bathtub, where the client has claimed that if you're in it, you feel sad. You feel some sort of emotion. So I'm going to sit in that bathtub, see if I feel sad, and see if I can be able to communicate with whatever spirit happens to be in that bathroom. Not only her, but her son has also felt that same presence or felt that same energy, that emotion in there as well. So I'll see if I can be able to pick up on that as well.
Will, are you doing this in the dark?
Yeah.
All right.
Go ahead and do this in the dark.
Let's see. Got the night shot on here.
Alright. Probably just sitting here. There we go. This is nice and comfortable. Might fall asleep in here. Who knows?
Will's all cozy in the bathtub there. Okay. We're gonna shut the door.
All right.
Lights out.
I'll see you guys.
All right, well, we'll see you later.
All right.
Hopefully.
All right. It is completely dark in here, so I'm going to go ahead and turn on my voice recorder. I got it right here ready to go. Hitting record. And I'm going to go ahead and put on these headphones. Edit this. All right.
I have my headphones on, so I can hear everything out of the voice recorder. And, yeah, so anytime I hear anything, I'm going to mark it and say, oh, I hear this. And then I'll go back and listen to it later. So let's go ahead and show you around and see what we can catch. Right now I hear voices outside, people talking. My name is Will, and I want to know, is there anyone in here with me? Right here is called a voice recorder, this device that I'm pointing at. If you talk into it, I could be able to hear you. So tell me, what is your name? I'm here because I want to talk to you. The family that lives here, they want to know if anyone else lives here with them. And so now you have an opportunity to be able to talk to someone. So what would you like to say? Did you and your boyfriend or girlfriend do drugs? Just so that way I know I'm not talking to myself. Can you make a noise for me? Can you make a knock like this? I gotta say, I don't feel sad or anything like that. I don't feel any negative emotion. Every once in a while, it sounds like someone is in here breathing. Or like they're getting ready to say something, like a kind of sound. Earlier I heard what sounded like a woman moan. Was that you? Okay, there was definitely a response on the voice recorder there. Could you say that again? Thank you. I saw a shadow in the mirror. You can't see it because of the IR light. But it definitely looked like there was someone standing on this opposite wall, so really facing right here, sitting on this side. It was like a shadow moved. I might have seen you. I definitely heard you. You're doing great. Keep talking to me.
So I just got out of the bathtub, and Jeff doesn't know about this yet, but two things happened. One, I was listening through the voice recorder and I asked, were you the woman that made that moan earlier? And immediately I heard what sounded like a breath, like someone else was in the room with me. And I was monitoring my own breath to, you know, kind of rule that out. and I heard it. And then I said, could you make that noise for me again? And 10 seconds later, I hear the exact same thing. And then just as I hear that other, what sounded like breath come through, above me, because I could see a mirror straight ahead, you could see that on the camera, above me, it looked like in the window was like a shadow. So right over my left shoulder, you had the window. It looked like there was a shadow going across the window, like there was someone or something standing above me, maybe looking down at me, breathing. It was kind of weird. I could only see it with my own eyes, but as soon as I raised the camera to point it into the mirror, you couldn't see it, not with IR. But you can only see it with the naked eye. It was kind of creepy. So next, Will, Emily, and I, we're going to go up in the attic. We're going to go lights out, and we're going to put the REM pod in the middle. And I'm going to go ahead and listen to the voice recorder with the headphones on. We'll ask a few questions and see if we can be able to get a response. See if whatever has been communicating with us tonight follows us up there. And yeah, hopefully we get it to where the REM pod lights up and there's something kind of hanging over. That would be pretty neat. Well, we'll see. All right, so we are in the attic. In the middle of the room is the REM pod. And straight ahead is Will and Emily. And my name is Will. And what I want to know first is there anyone up here with us? If there is, in the middle of the room, there is a red light. If you come to it and touch it, it will light up. Will is going to go ahead and demonstrate how to light it up for you. All you have to do is just touch it.
Simple as that.
That's it. It won't hurt you. I noticed the K2 meter is going off.
Are you evil?
Earlier I heard a woman moan. Was that you? Are you the man that was doing drugs in this house?
I'm sorry that your boyfriend was abusing you. Did he kill you?
If that man hurt you, touch that red light for me. Make it turn green. No, what'd you hear?
Like someone's walking up the steps.
Mm-hmm.
But like very, very lightly.
Very kind of heavily though. I felt like a cold, like, not a breeze, but like...
Like someone that lightly tapped. Did you just touch me?
Is there someone or something in our presence?
Could you make that go off? As simple as this. Just put your finger in there. Did your husband murder you in your bathtub? Yellow for yes, red for no.
Did he murder you? Sound like I said in tub, but I don't know.
I asked you a question. Did your husband murder you in your bathtub? Yellow for yes, red for no. Do you believe in the Lord Jesus Christ?
Does it sound like it said Beelzebub?
Do you believe in the Lord Jesus Christ?
Heaven?
Oh, snap.
Wreck?
Twenty-five? You got in a wreck when you were 25? Yellow for yes?
Alright guys, so we were listening to the spirit box. We didn't really get any, I guess you could say, answers that we could really make out. We did hear something that sounded like someone said, F you. And I told it to give us a sign that you're here, and we all heard footsteps and felt the floor shake. Mm-hmm. And another thing, the temperature here has gotten very, very, very cold.
And it's not just outside.
Yeah, it's not just outside, because don't forget, guys, we're in the attic. You know, heat rises. So, yeah, that's where we're at in our investigation for now. Still no answers from the REM pod, and very little answers from the K2 meter.
No, the REM pod hasn't gone off at all tonight. It's not once. Isn't it?
Because we always talk about that, of course, like the REM pod, how in some investigations it'll go off, and in others it won't. So it kind of rules out the possibility how we always speculate with equipment that's made for paranormal investigation. We don't put as much stock in it sometimes because does it give false positives? I don't think the REM pod gives false positives. I mean, tonight, for example, it's been on since we got here pretty much. Hasn't gone off once. We left that room, left the recorder going, still didn't go off.
I will say, though, it doesn't feel like it's a person. Well, more like a being almost. I can't explain it.
Whatever we're doing, what we're doing with stuff is smart.
Extremely
smart.
Clever. For sure.
See, right now, it's bucked up the yellow real quick. Yep.
It knows we're talking about it.
It's interesting that it always goes to yellow, too. And since you mentioned that, and when you were left the camera on it, talking to the guy in the living room, started talking about that gin. We started talking about a gin. Which is a type of a spirit, demonic spirit.
That's right.
And as soon as the lady mentioned that, when we're talking to them in the living room, spiked right up to yellow. Just right up to yellow. So that's pretty cool because usually you'll see it fluctuate. It'll kind of be a dim light or else it'll go all the way up to red. Sometimes it'll go somewhere in the middle, but this just solid yellow. So.
You said yellow meant yes, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yes for anything.
Yeah, and it never really went to red. It was just yes, yes, yes.
And if it did, it would just go real, real fast.
No. I had started reciting the Lord's Prayer before he came up here.
Mm-hmm.
And, like, instantly, real light coming up the steps. You said you were coming up the steps before you came.
Right,
but
right.
We did hear that on several occasions. But, whatever we're dealing with, dog, I think it's...
It's very smart.
Something
and
intelligent.
Fast.
I don't think a Civil War soldier. Well, I can't say that.
Well, it's true because like a Civil War soldier, and I guess I should keep this on here. If you think about this location, they talk a lot about the Civil War being in this area. But if Civil War soldiers that were in this area, a lot of them would probably be residual, which mm-hmm. don't interact with people. And in their state of existence, this house was not built. So their spirits would probably, if they were seen on these grounds, would probably be seen walking right through the wall, right through where the house sits. If something's up here in the attic, the least we can say is that it is intelligent. It's not residual unless it's a spirit of somebody that died in this house or that has some kind of strong attachment to this house and has come back here. But Civil War, you know, most likely, like I said, a lot of that would probably be residual at this point. I'm sure there are quite a few intelligent
spirits from the Civil War wandering around. But I just don't see them sitting up here in the attic. You know, I see them kind of outside in the yard and stuff like that if they were here, not hanging out in the attic.
I think whatever's going on in here, it has something to do with... I'm 95% sure it has something to do with the previous lady.
Yeah, I feel like something happened to her, for sure. I don't know if the man did it to her or did it to herself.
The investigators, he's in jail now. And then we heard that woman's voice. And then we heard something like her last breath. Like when you showed me that in the bathroom, that mm-hmm. sounded like someone's like last breath.
Sigh of relief or something.
And that, along with the grief that the lady downstairs said that she feels in the bathroom, kind of sounds like maybe she maybe committed suicide.
And that, yeah, that's in
that bathtub, that could very well be a possibility.
That is a good possibility.
And you know,
yeah,
renters are not going to disclose that.
Not if they don't have to.
Yeah, they're not going to disclose that.
And I don't think they have to disclose. I'll have to double check. I don't think they have to disclose suicide, just murder. All right. So
they don't
very
have
well
to.
Happened.
We had some very interesting evidence when we were doing this investigation, and the first thing that came through was when we were running an EVP session upstairs, and I believe this was when we were upstairs in one of the rooms, and we had all heard this sound that sounded like it was coming perhaps from downstairs. The husband and wife said they had not made any noises that even remotely would have sounded like this. So I felt like it was relevant. It was worth pulling out of the audio file and having it play for you.
I don't know. Maybe. I guess it depends on
that?
What time we start.
I don't know. Yeah,
it sounded
like it came from downstairs.
Yeah.
So what you heard there was me saying, I don't know. And all of a sudden there comes in this noise that sounds like a woo from somewhere in another part of the house is what it sounded like. We couldn't attribute this to anybody or anything. So like I said, I felt like it was worth pulling out just a fairly strange noise in general. The second thing that we came through, and actually the rest of them that came through Spirit Box. And this one was an interesting one because the owner had mentioned that she felt kind of strange in that upstairs bathtub. And we had already theorized that perhaps something happened in this bathtub. So I'll let you listen to this one and see what you think.
Did something bad happen in that big bathtub?
So what you're listening for there is at the very end of the audio clip, there's a voice that comes through and it sounds to me like it says it was a drowning. And there were a couple of other things, don't get mistaken, there were a couple of other things that came through just prior to that in the center of the audio clip. But at the very end is what you want to listen for. Now, because this was a question that we'd asked about a bathtub and about something potentially happening in the past in that bathtub, we thought that was actually quite relevant. Now, another thing that came through, this was one of the more clear responses that we've gotten on a spirit box, and certainly relevant to the situation, was this audio clip here that I'll play for you.
Oh.
So, obviously, the only thing that came through here in this audio clip was this loud female voice, and it says, need help. We're not exactly sure what she needed help with. We heard it at the time, and we started asking questions that were responses to it, like, what do you need help with, or how can we help you? But we weren't able to get any other responses to come through the spirit box that answered our questions. So we're kind of left up in the air as to what this female needed help with. Now, the last one that I have to play for you is kind of a strange one. And I say that because of what was spoken in here. Again, it was through the spirit box. And it was a male voice that came through. And I'll play that for you now.
What's causing that smell?
So at the time, we had been running a spirit box session in one of the upstairs bedrooms. And The men had all left and left only the female investigators as well as the owner of the home in the room. And we were sitting there and they started smelling a strange smell that smelled somewhat floral or somewhat sweet. And we were trying to decide exactly where that came from and couldn't find any source for it. So, of course, we ask, you know, what is that strange smell? And the response that sounds like it comes through is, I make them wash my hair. It's a male response, and it almost makes me wonder if this was perhaps some residual smell left over from maybe even a century ago. Maybe there was a man that lived on the property, owned servants or slaves of some sort, and he made them wash his hair. And the scent of the shampoo that they used is sort of acting like a residual haunting in this sense. But certainly strange, kind of a excellent investigation as far as evidence review goes. And we're looking forward to perhaps returning at some point and seeing what else we can find.